as you know, Steve, we've always been on an accelerated timeline because, you know, whether the governments in the West, industry in the West, and everybody in the West realize it or not, we at First Phosphate knew that this supply chain is critical and it's important to build it as quick as possible.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. Joining me now is John Passalacqua. He is the CEO of First Phosphate. And John, great to see you again. How are you?
Yeah, you too, Steve. Happy New Year to everybody.
Yeah, good to have you along. And thought it'd be a great opportunity for you and I to sort of kick off the year with some thoughts on some recent news out about China sort of proposing this export ban on battery cathode and lithium processing technology. And really more details became known to everyone over the holidays. And it really does put in perspective what you're doing, what others are trying to do, and what China is obviously thinking they need to do.
Yeah, so look, Steve, it's really major news here in the new year. This news came out over the weekend, and it's a response to a bit of a buildup that's been going on, mostly between the U.S., also Europe and China, with respect to the, you know, the first shot over the bow was the defense contractors and the computer chip makers. There was some, you know, retaliatory trade measures between China and the U.S. that started around, you know, at some point last year, really hit off here recently with the U.S. putting a ban on certain defense contractors from dealing with or selling product to China. As you know, there's been a massive interest and a massive move in many of the stocks that are related to defense contractors, and also the whole quantum computing, because they feel that's you know, a form of leapfrog technology that's going to be really, really in high demand here in the U.S. as the U.S. tries to build up a local you know, chip supply chain. We see now, this is extremely interesting, the response to that has been by China, not only on the chip side, but it's been now into the lithium processing technology side, and it's specifically LFP. Now, why is this important? China's basically coming out and saying, hey, this is just as important as computer chips. This is just as important as rare earths, gallium, everything else in there. So they're now elevating LFP technology. And they've also you know, discussed in that proposed ban, phosphate and phosphate technologies, lithium iron phosphate technologies, iron phosphate technologies. So that really is really a big moment here for First Phosphate and for anybody in the LFP space and the phosphate and the iron phosphate space in North America and anywhere in the world outside of China. As you know, we've been building this company very slowly over the last 2-3 years. And I think this is the moment of recognition of just how important this whole supply chain is, LFP and the phosphate, not only to China, but to the whole world. We now become in play at the same level as, you know, the defense contractors and the quantum chip makers. It's an incredible development. It's an incredible acknowledgement to the importance of the phosphate supply chain, the lithium iron phosphate supply chain, and the iron phosphate supply chain in the West. And First Phosphate has been building, delivering, and is at the top of that entire development of that supply chain in North America. So this is our moment. This is our moment to really shine and to show the world what we've been able to create here for the West.
So, John, just to get some perspective here, if people were, if there was no First Phosphate, for instance, what would a ban like this be doing to North America for China to do this type of ban? What would that, how would that have an effect on what's going on right now?
Yeah, so the ban is, China recognizes the technology is extremely important to their prosperity. So they don't want this technology to leave China, because they feel that, you know, as trade barriers start to go up, a lot of this supply chain is now going to start up in North America. So they don't want North Americans to have the ability to make this on their own. I don't know if that answers directly your question, but that is at the heart of it. So what the retaliation to all of this is going to be, well, you know, North America, Europe, we're going to have to build these our own supply chains in LFP, because the idea is that, you know, everyone would be required to continue to buy from China. So they're putting a line in the sand. They say, we want you to continue to buy from us. We don't want you developing this on your own anymore.
How important is the incoming President Donald Trump and the way he wants to have North American supplies of just about everything? I mean, he usually says America first, but certainly he's going to need some of that supply from Canada as well. So I would imagine that all the sort of things are lining up perfectly for what you've been talking about the last couple of years about why you're building First Phosphate the way you have.
That's exactly what it is. And we know, you know, we heard some, you know, rumblings out there that, oh, battery metals will not be so important under the Trump administration. Battery technology will not be important. He doesn't see it as important, but he sees defense and he sees defense contractors and he sees computer chips as extremely important to his platform. And now China said, hey, guess what? We're throwing into the mix into that game of the retaliatory measures. We're throwing in, anything related to LFP technology. So anybody who thinks that, Trump is not going to care on LFP, is not going to care on battery technology, especially the most advanced and the most popular out there like LFP, is dead wrong, because China's just thrown this whole thing into that big discussion of, what's going to happen here between the China and the US trade relationship. And LFP, phosphate, iron phosphate, lithium iron phosphate are now right at the center of that, damn smack at the center of that. So, I mean, geez, LFP battery technology, Trump, it's up there. It's up there in terms of defense contractors. It's up there in terms of quantum chips, it's the next slap that's come back towards America, and let's see how America responds to this.
Yeah. And lastly, John, does this now accelerate the timeline for the things that you want to accomplish as well? Do you feel the some pressure now to increase that timeline?
Well, look, as you know, Steve, we've always been on an accelerated timeline because, whether the governments in the West, industry in the West, and everybody in the West realize it or not, we at First Phosphate knew that this supply chain is critical and it's important to build it as quick as possible. We have been building it as quickly as humanly possible since the beginning. It's not that we build it any faster, because we've been on an accelerated timeline because we saw it as so critical. But this moment here basically tells the world, wow. It's important, and it's important what companies like First Phosphate are doing, that they're accelerating, and to continue to get them to accelerate this build out, because the demand here is going to be really massive for LFP. So we keep on our path. Our vision has always been the same. This is really just a validation of our vision since the beginning.
Yeah. John, well said. Thanks so much. Good to get you on and comment on what's happened over the weekend. Very significant news, obviously, and we'll continue to follow that story as well. So appreciate your time. Thank you.
Yeah, a great new year, a great validation of LFP, and a great validation of First Phosphate here. And just to set out the new year and set the path for this company, I couldn't be any happier. So thank you to you and your listener, Steve, and happy new year to everybody. And let's see how all this plays out.
All right, look forward to it. John Passalacqua, the CEO of First Phosphate.